What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So we're getting ready to take a little trip in the new truck. I got a load on the trailer that I picked up Friday and getting ready to head out with it. I'm not completely done with the truck. As I stated in the previous video, I believe, I got an email about a load and I need to make some money, pay some bills. So I don't have the headache rack on there yet and a few other little knickknack, just minor things, but I got everything else ready to go, I believe. So we're gonna go try it out and see how she does, how she pulls. Just from the short distance that I drove it, it seems like it's a lot stronger than the old truck. It should be with the 530 horse and the 1850 torque. So I figured you guys have watched the build process along. I don't usually do video and driving and whatnot. I think it's a little boring and there's enough trucking channels and stuff that does that. So I don't find it that interesting myself. But I figured for this, since you guys watched all the build process and everything, that you would probably want to go along for a little ride. So figured I'd take you guys along and see how the truck does. All right, guys, I have no idea if you can hear me or see me or whatever. I did change the camera around to a different angle right there. I've got the lights on right now, but I got to turn them out to be able to drive. Got done doing a pre-trip and everything. I don't see any issues, so we're going to get ready to head out. And I've got to stop and get a log boat somewhere on this trip. I remember that. I couldn't find my blank log book you're supposed to keep in case this e-log doesn't decide to work or something. But anyway, I don't know what to do with this gear shift yet. That's a little awkward for me. This truck is like exactly the same as my other truck. The other truck's got auto shift. I've been driving for 5 years, so this is awkward. Forgot to shift a couple times on the way up there to pick this load up. It's a little bit different. So, gotta get used to that and everything. Put the seatbelt on. I don't like this seat either. It's the same brand of seat. It's a National seat. But it doesn't lean back as far as my other seat did. I think I'm gonna take the seat out of my other truck and put it in here because I like it to lean back a little bit more. It doesn't hurt my back as bad. So we'll have to see on that deal. I'm gonna turn some of these lights out. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see or not, but it is what it is. Guys, I've decided to stop and get me a Subway, get some fuel, even though I didn't really need fuel. Auto shift, I could kind of eat somewhat and drive. Not so much with this, at least not taking off and whatnot. Didn't even really want Subway, but yeah, it's convenient. Show you the rest of it later. Really got the feel for this truck yet as far as the clutch engagement and shifting it and whatnot. I'm not used to it. It'll take a little getting used to where the clutch release point's at and all that good stuff. Come on, red light. Thank you.
All right, guys, I had to stop at the truck stop here. I got a log book just in case something happens to my e-log. You gotta have one. And I was gonna get some glass cleaner, but they didn't have any. All they had was those glass cleaner wipes, and those things will dry out before you ever use all of them. Kind of a one-time use deal from what I found. You buy the thing and clean your window one time, next time you're ready to clean it, they're all dried out. So, anyways, I'll get something somewhere else, I suppose. There's trucks parked over there. I actually got run off from this place several years ago because I pulled over there and I was going to eat my sandwich. And I hadn't been there like 10 minutes. And this woman came out there all mad, hollering at me, telling me I had to move right now. There's like five other trucks parked over there blocking the whole doggone thing. I said, yeah, okay. So I left. I didn't come back here. I didn't buy anything for a long time, probably a couple of years. Thank you. says I gotta turn right up here. Take a ride at the next intersection up here, which is breaking this thing. It's kind of a hit or miss. Sometimes it seems to work a little faster than others. Let's deal with that. Ahem. it's just right around the corner there is what it shows, like right there, but can't get to it.
Put my flashers on.
Ain't nobody behind me, but good practice. I just did not like going to places I've never been to before. You get in a mess like this. I looked this up on Google Maps and everything, you know, it's supposed to be a straight shot right there. It does not tell you they got a freaking steamroller sitting in the middle of the highway. Into sometimes. Look at this driveway right here. I don't know if I can blindside back in that right there or not, but I guess I'm gonna have to give it a try. Unless it loops around. I wonder if it loops around.
I have no daggum idea what this is.
but I do see a truck coming around from the other way. So it's possible.
Thank you.
straightforward on the map there. Just left out the park. They had a freaking roller in the middle of the road. And see, this road that I'm supposed to be turning on is not even on Google Maps. It's a new road that they just built. That's not on Google and it's not on the truck GPS. That's gonna show that I'm driving out through the middle of a field. Strap and see what they're gonna do with this mess.